Facial animation is entering a new era, and not just for metahumans. Whether I'm in Blender or Unreal Engine, with my method, it's just going to work, thanks to Unreal's 5.6 new facial motion capture feature. All I need is one single mono video. That's right. No depth sensor, no iPhone. Just a simple 5-year-old Android phone with a front camera. What you see here is the raw footage. No cleanup has happened, no fancy pipelines involved. The only thing I changed is that I redubbed it with a female vocal voice. This character driven by the original 52 ARKit Shapekeys, with a few more helping Shapekeys for wrinkles. I always finding new ways to build bridges between Blender and Unreal. And with a little trickery, this is exactly what I did here as well. If you want to learn it by yourself how to do this, the full breakdown starts now.
Hello and welcome back everyone. So the first thing you need is obviously Unreal's new 5.6 version. Then just grab any camera, phone or digital, doesn't matter, and film yourself doing whatever you want. Just heads up, it only recognizes faces, so don't bother recording anything else, even though it has a head. Or you can just grab something from the internet.
Catch me if you can, Mr. Holmes.
Now once you uploaded or downloaded that file to your PC, put it into a folder. In the plugins, look for Metahuman and tick in everything. And the most important one is the Metahuman animator depth. Now you will need to restart. The first thing you need to understand is this whole thing is built for metahumans, with their complicated weight-based face rig, wrinkles and everything. So you need to use a little trick to get around that. But whatever we do, we will need a metahuman in the scene. I not recommend messing up your original project with a random metahuman. What I recommend is just do a separate project just for this facial mocap animation retargeting. In 5.6, you can create metahumans inside the engine. It's no longer needed to be on the browser version. There are a bunch of tutorials on this already, so I'm not getting into that deeply. The point is to get a random metahuman in the scene. Doesn't matter which one. After open this up, you can just enable this missing stuff. Then it's going to need another restart. You can do a bunch of things here, but we just want one random one. We select one from the preset. Under assembly, I chose the EU optimized version, and we need to generate the rig for it. So we can click on this. Then we still need textures. We can download it at any size. Now just click around these tabs, because that green assembly button sometimes disappears, and this is how you get it back. Here we can rename the asset and choose where to place it. Once it's done, hit assemble and it will appear in your content browser after it created it. In Unreal, go to Tools and open up Live Link Hub. So this is where all the live real-time streaming stuff are should happen, but we are looking for a capture manager in this case. Just in case, hit this one as well in the Tools panel. Then go to Add Device, Mono Video Ingest, and then we will select it and go to our Take directory. So this is where we are taking our footage from our phone and send it over to the PC and put it into a folder. Don't surprise if you don't see any clip here, that's perfectly normal. Once you selected that folder, you can grab multiple clips or just a single clip and add it to the queue. Don't bother either if the footage looks weird, it's still going to work. Now I added it to the queue and hit start. And this is going to ingest the footage into your project so we can then use it for the metahuman performance. If it gives you an error and it stops around 99% or any random number in the progress, you can try to re-render your footage in Premiere Pro or any other software, then just use that or simply make a duplicate and rename it. I don't know why, but it's always worked for me if I encounter any issue. Once we are done with this, a new capture folder will show up. Now let's create a mocap folder. Inside the folder, right-click, MetaHuman, MetaHuman Performance. We'll open that up. First thing we will do is go over to the input type, and instead of depth footage, we are going to select monocular footage. Then we will go to our footage capture data and select our clip. And here we have our clip, and with that, my ugly face. So in the details panel for visualization mesh, we should select the MetaHuman that we have in the scene. Then we can go to the head movement mode and disable it or leave it on controlling. Usually you don't want to track the head movement because you should use the head movement from the body motion capture, which I do with Quick Magic. But I'm going to show you how to get the head and neck motion, because in some cases you might want that, but on its own it's not going to work perfectly. For that we will need to cheat a little, and I will get back to it later. For now, let's do it with disabled head movement. Last thing we can do is to go to advanced, and here we can enable natural pose calibration. It's not necessary, but I started my face in a natural pose, so I will have a reference, so I can enter that frame for better results. But as I said, it's optional. I'm going to use 0, or maybe frame 1. Next, we are just going to hit process. And it's already done. I mean, if you ever tried normal mocap with just Android with a CSV file, it's always so jittery, but look at that. This is awesome. Really, really minimal jitter and can be easily smoothed out later. Obviously, there are some limitations on what this camera angle can handle. But anyway, the only thing we need to do is to export the animation. Now, depending on the head movement, if we want it or not, we can export that as well, but it won't behave as it should. Let's just start with the head movement turned off. And I just made a tiny mistake, so I didn't select our own MetaHuman skeletal mesh and left it on the rig when exported. So to fix that, I'm going to export it again. But now I select the right skeletal mesh. And now it's working perfectly. Now let's import or migrate our own custom character to this project. Now in optimal case, your own character should have at least two separate rigs, one for the head and one for the full body. Now if that's not the case, it's not a problem. I just mentioned that to avoid any confusion, because the character is modular and I have separate rigs. You can check my optimization video about that if you are curious. On the exported animation asset, right click and retarget the animation to your own skeletal mesh. In my case, this is the head skeletal mesh. Export the animation. And surprise, surprise, we don't see anything happen. But this is how it should be, because I only wanted the curves and the length of the animation. Now I have all that, the only thing we need to do is to rename the curves to our own morph target curves, which you should already have here in your skeleton, if you have the ARKit shapekeys. If you don't have that, well, you have to create it manually, then sign in morph target for them. Now to rename the curves, we need to know which curves are the ARKit ones. And that can be really confusing, but luckily I created a full txt file for you that you can download in the description for a simple copy and paste. Shout out to Tom Halpin 8. I was creating this on my own when I stuck with the mouse, and I just came across with this thread, which was super handy, so huge thanks again. So you just hit F2 and copy the corresponding ARKit name, and as you can see, the blink already works. Now we need to do this on all 52. Let's speed this up. Now it can be annoying, but it took me a total of 6 minutes to do it. It's way faster alternative than removing the jitter by hand. There are many alternatives to automate this process, but they are all time consuming, so I'm not getting into that. But if someone has a simple Python script for that, I'm sure everyone would be happily accept that, including me. And once you rewrote it, it works brilliantly. However, one thing is good to mention here, and that is the mouse. So as you can see, it's a bit weird. What I found is that it works way better without the mouse close curve. So I'm going to delete this whole curve. If you don't want to delete it, you have to at least smooth it out. At least this is my experience. But maybe it's just me that can't articulate in real life. I don't know. I left some out, so I'm going to delete these remaining ones. And now if I look it back, it looks way better. Now for people that followed the wrinkle tutorial, fairly ask, what about the wrinkle curves? Well, we don't want to work extra minutes on this, so we will do it in a lazy way. That brings us to the Blender part, which we start with exporting this animation. So right-click on the asset, Asset Actions, Export, and use the following settings for the export. Make sure you export the source mesh, obviously morph targets, and then preview mesh as well. We need this because we need the head. The head must be visible in Blender in order to get the shape keys. And for both here, select Bake All. There is nothing else we need to do here, so we can hit Export. Now in the Blender, we can import this FBX and we can see it working as it should. If it doesn't, then either you use the wrong export settings, or perhaps you imported the Metahuman animation, not your skeletal mesh animation. You can see that it is exported everything, both the rig, the head mesh, and the shape keys as well. Now since we used FaceIt add-on, we have a super handy stuff here, which I didn't talk about yet. So under Mocap, there is a section Shapekey Retargeter. We can basically copy Shapekey based animations back to our character at any time. So even if you have a totally different looking head mesh, monster for example, but it has the same Shapekeys, you can still get that animation from that character to this one. We should not forget that we are still using the control rig as the main animation source for the Shapekeys. Therefore, we want to retarget that whole Shapekey action to the control rig itself. To do that, at the source object, select the mesh you just imported from Unreal. Not the rig, the mesh. For target, select control rig targets. Select your original mesh. And hit initialize retargeting. We can hit OK, and now we can see that it has found all the Shapekey data. Now hit retarget action. We can leave the source as is, and we can give a new action name to this. Check bake to control rig, but we don't need to set up anything here, and now we can hit OK. And we are not done yet. Here, select the Unreal's skeleton action that is automatically generated. Then you can give a name to a new control rig action. Then hit OK. And again, OK. And now we have the animation on our character. We can now hide the Unreal one. And it's working. It's awesome. And with this, we trigger the lazy part. Since if you remember, or if you will check the wrinkle tutorial, the drivers are set to copy the other Shapekey movements. So now if we will export the animation, it's just going to bring all the new curves with it. Here you can easily tweak, modify, or smooth out anything if you want. Now let's quickly export this. We are selecting the head parts and the rig, then export. Use the usual Unreal export version, uncheck this too. Then in Unreal I import it with setting the corresponding head rig, check in only animation, and make sure morph targets enabled. Open the animation, and now we can see that the wrinkles are working perfectly. Because as you can see, thanks to the wrinkle system, it just brings the needed curves with it automatically. And basically that's it. Isn't that easy and awesome? The only part that takes time is the renaming. Other than that, we get a clean, almost jitterless mocap in under a few minutes basically, which you can easily tweak inside Blender or Unreal through curves or anything basically. Now the only thing left is the head motion. Now as I said, typically we don't want to do this way. It should come from the source of the body mocap. But if you need that, there is a cheat way. It's a bit weird one. Now in the performance, switch this to control rig. I found that you don't need to reprocess it. You can just export it as is. So you export the asset with the head movement. And now you want to retarget this animation to your own rig. As you can see, it's behaving here in the retargeter as it should. Also, we don't bother with these warnings. So let's export this new retargeted asset and open it up. So it was looking cool in the viewport. It should work, right? Well, it should, but it won't. If you look at it, it doesn't do anything. Nothing in the curves, nowhere. There is basically no animation data that the head movement ever existed. Now, I had a hard time wrap around my head for this one, to be honest, and I believe it's kind of buggy, but we get around that. For that, let's add the level sequence up here, and we are going to bake this animation. You will get it in a second. If you did not open it up, look here at the outliners and click on this open level sequence. Now let's find the Metahuman body skeletal mesh and drag and drop it into the scene. And add it to the sequencer just like I do. We can close this. And now what we want is to add the animation which we got from the Metahuman performance. Now still nothing will happen, and that's because the control rig blocks the animation currently. I don't get into the detail, the easiest is just to delete it. We don't need it here. And now we can just see that it is moving around. You can see the neck, but it does what it should. Now let's find the end of the animation. Right there. Now right click and go and find big animation sequence. Name it. You can leave the export settings as is. Export. Now find that animation. Check if it is working. And now retarget this animation to the head skeletal mesh. And now if we open it up, it works perfectly. Obviously the shape keys are currently not, because you have to rename them here again. But this time we don't need to struggle with it, since the shapekey curves are the same. So we can just simply open the imported animation and copy all the curves from it. Then open this new one and just paste it, which I just did off screen. However, I did not copy the wrinkled ones because I'm going to export this to Blender anyway. Now in Blender, same method, you can use it again, the shapekey retargeter if you need to, but don't forget that this just retargets the shapekeys. For bone movement, we have to use Rococo. Just select the source mesh. My target is my main body rig. Add the bone list, set both to rest, and hit retarget. And now it's working as it should. For extra, I can just delete the keyframes on the bones that basically has zero movement and create something or blend it with a different animation. So back in Unreal, here's the animation. You can add the notify here for sound, for redubbing. It's for just demonstration purposes. You should not do this in a game. Now let's see what we have.
Look at how easy they made this. It's crazy. Also, why I'm always naked in these videos.
That AI voice is killing me. Anyways, thanks for watching. I hope it helped. If it did, please leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.
You take care of my pipes, I can take care of your pipe.
Ma'am, I do my own plumbing.